Hi, welcome to MAA-250, this is Project 2. We will be discussing an interplanetary satellite mission. The mission we have chosen is the New Horizons. This is Pluto and Titan interface.
New Horizons is an ongoing mission funded under the New Frontiers program with NASA. The craft was launched in 2006 and this past summer flew past Charon and Pluto, where it completed its scientific objectives of mapping the surface of these bodies, characterizing Pluto's atmosphere and its escape rate, mapping the surface temperatures on Pluto and Charon, and searching for rings and additional satellites around Pluto. This data will finish transmitting over the coming months, and New Horizons objectives progress towards conducting the same studies on a Kuiper Belt object within the next 5 years.
The New Horizons spacecraft is made up of several components in order to work in conjunction with the seven instruments placed on the spacecraft. These components consist of the structure, command and data handling, thermal control, the propulsion system, guidance and control, communication, and power. All in all, the total mass of this spacecraft will be 478 kilograms with full of fuel. Again, and the scientific equipment that was placed on the spacecraft. The seven instruments placed on the spacecraft consisted of Ralph, Alice, Rex, Lori, Swap, Petsy, and SDC. These instruments were a combination of different spectrometers and imagers used to take data when they passed through Pluto and the Kuiper Belt. Each instrument had to be careful with how much power it used, and all had to be ran on one thermoelectric radioisotope generator. New Horizons is powered by one radioisotope thermoelectric generator. This provides power through the natural radioactive decay of plutonium dioxide fuel, which thus creates a lot of heat. The RTG works by harnessing the heat produced and turns it into electricity. Upon launch, the RTG was capable of supplying 245 watts at 30 volts of direct current to all the systems. This power, however, was managed by the systems on the spacecraft in order to prevent it from exceeding the steady output from the RTG itself. Upon launch, the RTG was able to harness heat from a temperature of 275 degrees within its casing, and by the time it reached Pluto, it would be estimated to be harnessing heat from a temperature of 208 degrees Celsius.
Detailed information on these topics and more about the New Horizons mission can be found in our research papers.